Sixers rally from 22 points down to win a dramatic 102-100 victory over Portland. Now, of course, they got help tonight to make sure that all the calls were even up. Pacers rally from 22 points down to win a dramatic 102-100 victory over Portland. Now, of course, they got help tonight to make sure that all the calls were even up. With a big steal here, Lowe and Waiters. Waiters hits the pass to Kellogg, two of his game-high 35. The Pacers are within 9. Now, Calvin Natt helped Portland to maintain the lead in the fourth quarter. He had 20, and Portland led 90-83. Now, here comes the comeback. George Johnson will hit 96-95 Portland. And with the score tied at 98-98, the Pacers will miss. Kellogg just barely, but watch Stipanovich with the rebound to put the Pacers ahead. With the score tied then, Kellogg will hit two free throws to make it 102-100. That set up the final dramatic seconds of the game.
Thompson outside, 6 seconds left. Right side, it'll be Kenny Carter trying to tie it. He gets it inside, Stipanovich steals.
That's it,
the ball game is over. The Indiana Pacers have defeated the Portland Trailblazers 102-100, and 12,488 are on their feet and in jubilation in Indianapolis tonight.
We stayed together, you know. I kept telling them that, hey, they're going to start missing. We're going to start making them, and it happened.
We went from 20 or 22 down to 13 down at the half, and we came in here a little higher. We were up. We were, you know, it's a good psychological factor to come in, you know, only down 13 when you've been down 22 with maybe 5 or 6 minutes to go in that second quarter. It was just an uphill battle from there on out, and we managed to come up with enough big plays to win it tonight.
Sure, the Lakers are happy because of that.